Hi, UUMAN family. I just put the final edits on the first ever UUMAN virtual Christmas pageant, Refuge in a Stable. The kids have worked really hard on this, overcoming the obstacles of having to work on Zoom, acting to a screen instead of to each other, and I overcame the obstacles of trying to figure out how to make it all happen in 4 days. And I think we did it, because what is 2020? But an opportunity to have a lot of obstacles and figure out how to overcome them and find something beautiful and special. So I hope you enjoy this beautiful and special pageant written by Rafaella and performed by the UUMAN Youth.
Not so long ago, in a not so faraway land, a man named Joseph was looking for a sanctuary in South Georgia. He, his pregnant wife Mary, and their younger daughter were immigrants. ICE had been going through neighborhoods looking for families to detain. Joseph heard of a small church with a farm that helped families in need. He hoped that the church would be able to help.
Joseph and his family traveled for days on buses, cars, and on the backs of trucks. Mary was extremely pregnant and very tired. She knew she could give birth at any time, maybe even before her family arrived at the church. She was excited for the birth of her second child and wanted her family to be safe. Even though she was worried about what could happen, she was willing to risk it to keep her family together.
After several days, they reached their destination, and Joseph immediately ran up to the door of the church. As Mary walked up the steps, she noticed the chalice on the top of the roof. Joseph knocked on the door and the minister walked out.
Do you have a place for my family and I to stay? We've been traveling for several days and my wife is expecting a baby.
You are welcome here. I see that your wife is very pregnant.
We also heard that your church has a place for us to stay. We are afraid that we might get deported.
Perhaps you should stay in the stables.
Thank you. You are very kind.
You will be safe there. The stable is far away from the troubles of the world.
I will go and get married.
The stable was a small building in the backside of the church's property that the youth used. It also doubled as a place for families in need to stay.
It isn't much, but there's mattresses on the floor with some pillows and blankets. We have tried to make it as comfortable as possible.
It is nice to have a warm space where we do not have to be afraid.
Yes, we haven't felt safe in a long time.
Soon it was obvious that their new child was to be born. The minister hustled everyone out, and a midwife, who was a member of the congregation, came in to assist, and soon Mary gave birth to her new baby boy.
Meanwhile, some of the local animals who had wandered in from other parts of the farm gathered outside the door. They knew something wondrous had occurred and they wanted to see for themselves.
Finally, one of them, being a little more curious and a little braver than the others, pushed open the door and snuck quietly into the room.
Can we come in? Wow!
One by one, the animals quietly entered into the room to see the miracle that was this new life.
Oh, come in. Bring your friends, bring your neighbors, bring your whole family. Oh, come on in. There is room in the stable for everyone.
Who is this?
This is our new baby.
This baby is beautiful.
He's a miracle. He's one of a kind.
I take to the sky, so I need to come into the stable. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Come in, come in. Bring your friends, bring your neighbors, bring your whole family.
As the animals settled in around Mary and the baby, a farmer appeared at the door.
Oh, good lady, please let us come in. We heard that a family is staying here tonight and have come to offer our help to them.
But how did you know? Who told you to come here? Did I send you?
I can tell you how we came here. We were in the fields tending our sheep when suddenly we saw the chalice on the top of the church light up. We were terribly frightened because we knew that meant someone could be in trouble. But one of the children calmed us and said, "Do not be afraid, for I bring good news. A family seeking sanctuary found us, and they are about to have a baby. Everyone is coming to the stable to help. So we decided to come to see this great event for ourselves.
I know these good people. They are farmers and volunteers who help those who are without resources. They are very poor, and yet they still care for others as well as themselves. You are welcome here.
I am a lowly carpenter, poor like you. Please come in. Our space is your space.
These are more volunteers. We have a lawyer, a doctor, and a social worker. They want to help you so you don't have to hide anymore.
We are people who have helped others like you with health issues or documentation.
Unfortunately, we recently noticed that lots of you have come here to this place when the chalice on the roof was lit. So we followed the light of the flame to the church, hoping we could be of use.
Each of them stepped forward and laid down one resource that they brought, kneeling at the foot of the minister as they did so. One quietly listened to the baby's heart, then to Mary's heart, smiling in such a kind way. One had papers they needed to help Joseph fill out and sign, and the other talked to the family about the options they could have for the future.
We shall leave you now, for we can see you are tired. We have helped you as much as we can tonight. We feel honored to have been here this night, for we know your son can grow up to become a great and wise leader. We hope your family stays safe.
And with that, they turned and disappeared into the night. Sensing it was time for them to leave as well, the local farmers and volunteers tiptoed out of the stable so as not to wake the sleeping baby.
It is time for me to leave as well so you can get your rest. I'll check up on you tomorrow. Good night. If you need me, I'll be in the main church.
Even the animals drifted away to their own separate parts of the church's property, for they were tired and in need of a good night's sleep themselves.
What shall we name him? I was thinking we might call him Jesus, but what do you think?
I think that is a perfect name. But now we should let your mother and Jesus get some sleep. Come, daughter, we will go to a different room in the stable and make a bed.
What is so special about this night, about this child? We are poor people from humble families. Is there something that makes my baby so special? And if he is so special, what is expected of me as his mother?
I want to hold my baby brother.
Would you like to hold the baby? Would you like to see him smile? Can you make your arms a cradle and rock him for a while? This gift that I've been given is yours as much as mine. Would you like to hold the baby? Take your time. Take your time. As the girl embraced the baby, Mary whispered low, "This child is more than we can ever know. For his eyes reflect our goodness, his heart reveals our soul. His gentle breath can touch our very soul. So wrap this precious baby in a blanket of your own and love him so his spirit will be free. Hold him close in sorrow and hold him close in joy. Hold him close, however life may be."
Her firstborn smiled at her face radiant with all the joy and love she was feeling inside. She knew she would never forget the night her baby brother was born.
Mary would not forget either, and although she could not know where his life would eventually take him, she did know her Jesus was very special and could one day be an important leader.
But now Mary's path was clear. She would care for him and love him and share him, for she knew in her heart that he was not hers alone to hold.
Jesus, just as the one he was named after, could indeed grow up to be a very important person to the world. Maybe he would be a great teacher or an important spiritual leader.
One thing she did know was he would be a true friend to the poor and the powerless, believing that all people deserve to be treated with kindness and respect.
And so each year we celebrate the birth of Jesus of Nazareth at Christmas time, eager for the joy and hope that belongs to this season.
For what started in a manger long, long ago in Bethlehem, with the birth of Jesus, continues today in this little church with the chalice on the roof.
His message of love and peace and goodwill to all people continues.
A message spoken to those who have ears to hear, eyes to see, and hearts to receive.
The birth of Jesus was a holy night.
The birth of every baby is a holy night.